Hi y'all. Welcome back. This is Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux, episode... what is this? 15? We are on take 3 of trying to finish level 12 of the dungeon. We've had a couple disappointing runs, but you know, I'm not going to get discouraged because... Well, let's be honest, it's been a little easy up to this point. I mean, we had the level with the Zills, which even that would have been easy if I bothered to actually read the manual and realize that I could use free action to negate the effects of the Zill's paralysis. And other than that, it's pretty much been a cakewalk up to this point. I mean, playing as a cleric, pretty OP. I mean, I wouldn't go so far as to say that the game's only beatable as a cleric. I'm sure it's possible to beat it as a warrior. Maybe not a thief. Maybe it's possible to beat it as a magic user. But as a cleric, let's face it, you have the best possible odds of survival. Which, you know, I'm not doing this as, like, a super challenge to myself, but it's nice to actually have something put me in my place for once. The music, by the way, is the soundtrack to Shadow of the Colossus, which is one of my standard soundtracks that I listen to. I've played it a few times during this Spelunky streams. So I do have a plan for dealing with the fears this time. I sort of tried the plan in the last video, which was using the potion of invisibility to try to slip past the fears, and it didn't work. I think the reason it didn't work was because when I entered the camp menu, they were already in the middle of an attack. So as soon as I exited the camp menu, the fears executed their attack and I barely had any health left, so they killed me before I was able to actually drink the potion. However, I am pretty sure that the potion would protect me against the fears if I drank it when they weren't about to kill me. Oh, I thought I saw a button on this wall, but I guess not. Okay. So the plan this time is, right before I teleport into that room with the three fears, I'm going to drink the potion of invisibility, and then I'm just going to book it. I'm just going to make a beeline to try to get past the fears as quickly as possible, and hopefully find the exit as quickly as possible. I don't know. Honestly, I don't know how it's going to work out for me. It's possible that the potion won't work, or the fears will still be able to hit me, and I'll get trapped and I'll die again. That's a possibility that I'm ready to accept. But honestly, I don't know how else to deal with that room with the three fears. I mean, my strategy of teleporting in, getting a hit off, and then immediately teleporting back isn't going to work. Yes, cause critical wounds. That's the spell I want to cast. Oh, good god. Okay. Man, I thought that thing was farther away from me than it was. What happens when you can't cast spells and look at your map at the same time? So yeah, I can't just teleport in, get a hit off, and then teleport back because there's three of them in there. And with them ganging up on me like that, I just don't have a chance. I guess I could play it like extremely cautiously and get a few hits off, teleport back, and then rest. Get all my spells back. But honestly, I'm not sure if the monsters regain hit points when you're resting or not. And even if they do, or even if they don't regain hit points, that's still a really boring, tedious way to try to get through this. You know, I want to I want to take some risks. I want to try some things I've never tried before. I mean, I've had that potion of invincibility for most of this game, and this seems like if there's an opportune time to use it, it seems like it would be now. So, I don't know. Your guess is as good as mine. If it doesn't work, then try again next time. Try a different strategy. Maybe I'll try the extremely patient, you know, rest every time strategy. Although that seems like a pretty cheesy way to do things. I have a good feeling about this run, though. I was playing some Dark Souls earlier. I actually had the day off because it's the primary elections in the state of West Virginia. And I don't normally vote in the primaries, which I probably should, but I don't know, it's really difficult to form an opinion of the best candidate. I mean, obviously, if I'm voting in a general election, I have a better idea of who to vote for. But for local primaries, I just don't have enough information to make an educated decision about that. For presidential primaries, I can probably see a reason to vote in those, although I haven't voted presidential primary before. But anyway, I had the day off, and I was playing a little bit of Dark Souls, and I finally beat the first real major boss in the game, the Taurus Demon. I haven't played Dark Souls in about, well, a couple months now, but I decided to download it and fire it up again, and it took me quite a bit of retrying, dying and getting my souls and leveling up, but I finally did it, and I felt pretty good. I also finally beat the knight that you run into shortly before the Taurus Demon that's guarding a ring. And in a way, I think that was more difficult than the actual boss. I died so many times to that damn knight. Ridiculous. It only took me 2 tries to beat the Taurus Demon too. Granted, the way I beat the Taurus Demon was a little cheesy. I did the strategy of, for anyone who's played Dark Souls, I did the strategy of going up onto the tower and doing a falling thrusting attack. If you do that, it takes down a quarter of the Taurus Demon's health. So I did that. I wasted those cure serious wounds, but I'll probably have to rest again soon anyway. So I did that 4 times, and I beat the Taurus Demon that way. The knight actually took a lot of, like, I actually had to learn how to do combat well to kill the knight, and it took me a while, but I eventually got it. So I'm taking that as a good omen. I did well in Dark Souls, hopefully I'll do well in Dungeon Hack also. Actually, that Dark Knight, the knight that I fought, looks kind of like this. Sort of just dark armor with a dark helmet. This guy's a little chubbier than the knight I fought, though. I'm going to fill out as much of the map as I can before I start teleporting again, because I felt like that was a good way to keep things straight in my mind. Let's see. Okay, I actually forget which of these teleporters go where, so I'll try this one first since I don't have to fight any monsters on the way back to it. No, you don't. Take that. Oh, that would be a funny way to cheese a monster. Just repeatedly close a door on it. But it would probably be difficult to actually deal damage to it that way. Wait. Did it close the door as it was dying? That's weird. Oh yeah, it's one of those. My favorite enemy in the whole game. You know, the living muck enemy is also supposedly one of the nastier enemies in the game. And I felt like I did okay against the living mucks. Right, there's only one of them, so this strategy actually seemed to work pretty well. Excellent. Have I been here before? I don't remember this button. I'm not sure. By the way, someone's mowing grass outside, so apologies if you hear a lawnmower. I'm not sure if the mic can pick that up or not. I tried messing with my microphone noise gate, which I probably should have done before. anything below a certain level of volume, and the mic just shuts off. Like, if I'm not talking, the mic just shuts off completely. Or, I mean, it doesn't shut off, but it doesn't record anything in that instance. And I did that so hopefully when I'm not talking, the lawnmower wouldn't be audible. So hopefully I have this set right. If my voice cuts out or anything, then I apologize. I'm gonna have to mess with the settings a little bit more. I think I got it right though. I mean, I don't know what someone's doing out mowing the lawn on this beautiful May day. And don't they realize I'm trying to record video games here? I mean, have some common courtesy, people. I still have a heel, right? Yeah. So someone suggested that the Slay Living spell, the reason it worked when I used it with a scroll, but it hasn't worked when I actually cast it, is because maybe the scroll has a better chance of working than the actual spell. Which, I'm not sure if that's the case or not. Could be. But it's a save versus death attack, which means that the enemy gets a saving throw, and if it doesn't make the saving throw, it immediately dies. A saving throw is just, In older editions of D&D, there's a save versus poison and a save versus paralysis. It's a way of determining if your skills are good enough to endure certain effects or not. So it stands to reason the higher level enemies would have a pretty good chance of saving versus death. So once again, not sure how useful any of my attack spells actually are. Alright, so I guess that's it for this section. So time to go back to that other teleporter now. I should probably go ahead and rest now that there are no enemies nearby. Go ahead and cast Create Food and Water. I guess I'm just going to stick with my spells. I don't think there are anything that would help me that I'm not already using. And I know me sitting here, me obsessing over what spells I'm using isn't entertaining for anyone, so this will probably be fine. It's not like I'm actually using any spells other than healing spells. Alright, ready to roll. Oh wait, I didn't even realize that was a key. Probably good that I noticed that. I'm glad I haven't... Probably don't even need to fight that thing, really. Oh, it's too late, I already aggroed it. Yeah, I'm glad I haven't gotten stuck again. That video where I spent all that time trying to figure out which way to go was kind of a pain in the ass. Oh, hey. I should probably get rid of harm. That doesn't seem to be doing me any good. I'm not sure what the spell actually does. Like, I know it's bad for enemies, but I don't know what the actual effect is. So my Etrian Odyssey 4 game is also going well. I don't know how I ended up playing 3 super hard RPGs at the same time, but that's kind of how it's worked out. My characters just hit level 20, which is the first level where they have access to the next tier of skills. I said earlier that I thought the level cap was 40, because there are 3 tiers of skills, and the first extra tier unlocks at level 20, and the second extra tier unlocks at level 40. So I thought that was the highest. Someone said the level cap is 99, though, which I don't know if levels 40 through 99 are just going to be like post game content, or if there's just that much to the game after level 40. Eyes on the prize, Duke. Those stairs are within my grasp. Didn't even seem... Oh, Duke of the Monk grazes the monster. That's interesting. Wonder what that means. Like, I wonder how much damage that translates to. Because bone freezes the monster. Well, it's better than missing, I guess. Gotta be careful, though. Okay. I guess I got it. Hopefully, using the microphone noise gate also prevents you from hearing my key clacks. Which I can see how that would get annoying after a while. I mean, you can hear them while I'm talking, because the noise gate is not in effect while I'm talking. But hopefully when I'm not talking, it mitigates that a little bit. I guess the fears I used, harm and cause critical wounds again, they did seem to die a lot faster than they would have otherwise, so maybe those spells are worth keeping around. Gold coin. Cha-ching. Alright, jerk. Come on. I'm not going to fight you in the dark. Probably a Gru. And since it's pitch black, I'm going to get eaten by you. Did I get him? Or did he go through the teleporter? Oh, he went through the teleporter. I should have just let him be. There's no reason I had to follow him through the teleporter. Ow. Look at how pathetically, like, that one was okay, but that first one was like an invisible sliver of my life bar. Well, see, that one... so disappointing. Come on, are you gonna come after me or not? For a monster called a fear, you're kind of a wuss. How come that thing can hit me when it's dark? That's what I'd like to know. This would be so much easier if I didn't have to worry about getting it to a place where I can see it. Alright, what else do I have here? Firestorm. Let's try it. Don't know where you came from, guy. So yeah, of the three super difficult RPGs I'm playing right now, I'd say Dark Souls is probably the hardest. This game would be the hardest if I wasn't playing as a cleric. I mean, being a cleric really is easy mode in this game, sad to say. See, when I cast Firestorm, it doesn't tell me if I actually hit or not. I wish it told you every time you attacked if you hit or not. I mean, just so you're 100% sure. I don't know if I can attack that thing through the teleporter or not. I've kind of been dodging around it. Okay, that thing went through the teleporter. That thing can stay there for all I... Oh, jeez. Maybe not. Okay. Alright, victory music. I'm going to use you to visualize a victory. At least monsters don't seem to respawn while you're resting. That would be a real bummer. Like in Dark Souls, every time you rest at a bonfire, all of the enemies respawn. Although, I don't know, maybe some of them do. I don't know where the troll came from. There's something in that room that I don't know where that came from either. What the? What? Why can't I see it? Can fears go invisible? Or is that a glitch? I can see it on the map, but I couldn't see it. That was so weird. Did I kill it? Or did it go back through the teleporter? Oh man, this game... Every time we play it, there's another surprise. Alright, what else? Get some of these other buffs out of the way, I guess. Yeah, cast aid. Excuse me, my throat's a little bit hoarse today. And put Trusane back on, why not? I guess I killed it, I sure don't see it anywhere. Man, that was weird. I like how he's surprised every time he enters the dark area. Hey! All of a sudden, I can't see anything. But you think after the 40th time that happens to him, he'd wise up a little bit. Okay, just a troll. Good. Good, good, good. Oh yeah, that's right. There's no reason to actually go into that room. I've been in there before. I cleared the fear out of it and there was nothing. At least the fears kind of lose their aggro sometimes. Damn it. Don't. I got totally confused as to which way I wanted to move. Okay, this is where I would use the potion of invisibility. I mean, it's worth a shot, right? Now you see me, now you don't. Okay. So if I attack, that'll immediately wear off. So, what I want to do is... Okay. So I'm surrounded. But I do have my wand of distance. Now, I don't know if using a wand counts as attacking or not. So this would be a good chance to discover that. Alright, so I want to turn... clockwise, and then immediately use a wand of distance. Right, doesn't say the invisibility wore off. Oh my god. Oh my god. Go away, troll. Go away, fear. Right, so the wand's out of charges. And... okay, well... I might have made a breakthrough here. If those monsters don't follow me, then I'm in good shape. Okay, my invisibility is definitely gone now since I attacked. So I'm praying that A, those monsters don't follow me, and B, there wasn't a key or something back there that I need. It looks like these monsters are kind of congregating around this general area. Of course, if the stairs aren't down here, then I'm going to have to go back up and go back through there. But, now that I'm on this side of the teleporter, it should be easier to draw them out and deal with them one at a time. Alright, I feel good about how the strategy is working out for me. However, I don't have the, brass or copper. I don't have that key, and I don't know where it is. That might be it. I didn't really notice as I was looking it through this area, or one of those monsters might drop it. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and rest, now that I'm sort of in a monster-free zone, just to be as cautious as possible. And hopefully... it'll be easier for me to deal with those hideous ambulatory brains. Still using aid and prayer, because why not? Okay, so I'm on a quest for a bronze or copper key. I don't remember if that lock is bronze or copper. Alright, that's club, so it's not that. I'll pick that up just to get it out of my sight. Alright, I have much more room to maneuver now, so it should... battle should go a little bit more in my favor. Alright, I drew two of them out instead of one, but that should be okay. Still have room to move around. Use a firestorm. Right? That was effective. Let's get a little bit more distance between me and that fear. I feel weird calling these things fears. Cleric level 18, okay. Boy, I thought that would have happened sooner. Oh well. I don't know. It's a dumb name for a monster. Or it's a dumb name for this kind of monster. When I think of a monster called a fear, I would think of one where it's spelled F-E-A-R, and it's like a specter or a... you know, some sort of spiritual creature that haunts your dreams, not a krang. Not a disgusting brain monster. We call it an ooh. That would be a more apt name for it. What's wrong, troll? Too quick for you? Hopefully the key that I need is just in this area somewhere, and I don't need to go back and retrace my steps completely. I got a little bit lucky with my strategy of running past all those enemies. If there was another monster zoo down below that one, then I could have been in serious trouble. If I got trapped between two huge groups of enemies, it could have been the death of me. But luck was in my favor that time. So once I make it past this level, hopefully things will go a little more smoothly for me once I no longer have the fears to deal with. I don't know, there might be another enemy that's tougher than the fears in this game, but I doubt it. About a firestorm. Oh, okay. Never mind. You're critical. How about cause critical? Does that do anything for you? Oh. I guess I have to be next to him, huh? Dang it, they didn't teach me that in cleric school. This is the monster. Great. Kind of interesting that it has like levels of success. Like it said that I grazed the monster a few times. Kind of interesting. You think it would be like a hit or miss proposition. Right, I don't have the moonstone yet, right? No. Ah, excellent. That's the copper key that I need. That's the moonstone that I need. So the question is, do I even want to open the moon door? I don't know. The stairs might be behind it, I guess. Or they might be behind the copper door. If they're up here, if the stairs are in this area, then I don't know what to do. I don't know how to get in here. Maybe there's a teleporter somewhere that leads in there that I haven't discovered yet, but if not, then I might have some figuring out to do. Which I'm not opposed to. The way I'm playing Dark Souls, I mean, I've watched one full playthrough of it, one partial playthrough, and I'm currently watching another full playthrough. And to me, the difficulty of Dark Souls will be the actual combat. That's what I find fun about that game. That's what I find challenging about that game. I would probably never figure out some things in Dark Souls if I didn't watch people play it first. So, you know, I play different games for different reasons. Don't really know where I was going with that. Glad I killed that thing before I got backed into that corner. That would have gone poorly for me. Oh, some armor there. Doesn't look like it's magical, which means it's probably not worth my time. But you never know. I guess the difficulty with this game is the combat as well. I know I compare this game to Eye of the Beholder a lot, but Eye of the Beholder is like my main frame of reference for this kind of game. Like, I played Dungeon Hack as a kid, but I never played it to the extent that I played Eye of the Beholder. But that's sort of... That's my 90s RPG of choice. Or it's the one that I played extensively anyway. And in Eye of the Beholder, there's a lot more puzzle solving, a lot more, you know, figuring out what to do, stuff like that. And the combat, I don't think, is quite as difficult as it is in this game. Because you have a full party to fight with instead of just one character. So instead of just a cleric, I would have a cleric, a fighter, and probably a magic user, and maybe a thief. I think thieves are actually useful for something in Eye of the Beholder. Eye of the Beholder and Dark Souls are actually kind of similar, because you don't have a map in either game. There's a lot of exploration. Oh, great. Man, I thought I cleared that room out. Both of those pieces of armor are probably pretty crappy. So I could probably just leave this area, but you know, there's only one of these guys, so I should probably be okay. Hacky potion. Didn't I find another one of those at some point? I seem to remember picking up a khaki potion. Oh, monster detection. Huh. Maybe not. It seemed weird to me. I must have picked one up at some time. Because I remember thinking that green color doesn't look khaki to me. Khaki is more of like a light tan. Oh well. Alright, so this door... Oh. I guess the lock's on the others. Oh wait, is that just where that... That must just be where that copper door led. And I found an alternate route. Well, I really hope the stairs are here, because if not, then this video might go on another 20 or 30 minutes. Interesting. All right. Well, the stairs must be somewhere in this section, and I have no idea how to get there. And this corner of the map is now once more full of monsters. Great. I'm gonna go back and look at that armor and just make absolutely sure that it's not worth getting. I mean, it's non-magical. Might as well go ahead and open this door while I'm here. What am I using now? Is that just... I can't drop anything there. Why not? Okay, that's just plate mail. But it's magical, which means one better than the field plate mail. And it doesn't want you to drop anything in the doorways, I guess. Okay, well, now what? I guess the next thing I have to do is start looking for secret doors that I might have missed. There might be a secret door in this room, actually. I never did explore that room thoroughly. At least I don't think I did. I cleared it out in the last video, and I kind of gave it like a once over, but I wasn't really looking for secret doors at the time. Once again, killed it with no death animation. Kind of unsettling. Alright, if one of these walls was illusionary, I would have been able to see it, but... just in case. Alright, no illusionary wall here. Might be an illusionary wall in this room. I mean, maybe true sight doesn't work, or true seeing doesn't work 100% of the time. Alright, so nothing in this corner, unless there's a secret door here. Yeah, there's a secret door in one of these dark areas. That could be what I'm missing. Wait, what just happened? Oh. I got confused there for a second. Alright. Nothing here. Whoa, what? Okay, when I stand here and I walk forward... or was it here? Man, that was so weird. On one of these squares, when I walk forward, it like teleported me up here. That was so strange. That happened the first time, and I was like, am I tripping? Oh well. Definitely nothing there. Unless there's a secret door right behind this teleporter. Okay, nothing. Alright, so now what? Man, this giant cross-shaped section of dungeon seems suspicious to me. That means I have to go all the way back to this teleporter to check that section out again. Because when I teleported in here, there's nowhere else to go. Well, once more into the breach, I guess. Alright, I actually don't need to be in this room. Don't follow me. Where do I need to go? I need to go around this way. Man, that's a lot of monsters. Really bums me out that the stairs weren't in that lower part of the dungeon. I was really hoping they would be. I get trapped, I no longer have a wand of distance or an amulet of imminent return. So I'm gonna have to be extremely careful. Maybe I can lose that fear. Maybe if I get far enough away from it, it just won't follow me. You have to lose your fear. You have to find your courage. Really glad these monsters don't just keep following you, hunting you down to the ends of the earth. How it is in Dark Souls, and it's no fun, let me tell you. I should probably rest. I wonder... if I go up into this... well, no, there's a monster there. If I go up here, I'll probably be far away enough from everything to rest. Oh, right, the spikes. Damn. I'm glad my health wasn't lower. Okay. This is still going well for me. I've hit a little bit of a stumbling block, but I'm still confident that I'll be able to finish this level in this video. Confidence levels are high. Alright. next course of action. Clear out these three enemies. Hopefully this one doesn't open that door and fight me and I can just bypass it. If it does, it's not the end of the world. Oh. Well, it opened the door. Are you coming out? Whoever you are. Wait. It's invisible again. What the heck? So weird, but even though it's invisible, I can hit it. Very, very odd. I mean, they've never done this before, right? All right, the spikes. There's another monster in that room now? What the... I mean, since multiple of these things are invisible, I'm guessing it's not a glitch. Just weird that I haven't seen that before now. And it's only... I mean, if it was all of them that were invisible, then that might be a glitch. Like, there might be something wrong with that one particular sprite. But it seems like only some of them are invisible. Really odd. I don't know, maybe they are all invisible now. Hard to tell. I did read something. Maybe it was in the manual, maybe it was in the wiki or something. They mentioned that these things are invisible. I was like, what is it talking about? They haven't been invisible so far. But maybe I've just gotten lucky up to this point. Should have done my multiple hammers trick again. Well, this might be a long one, folks. Hope you're comfortable. Hope you have some food and or a beverage to tide yourself over. Oh no. Something behind me now. Please die, troll. Please die, troll. Please die, troll. Please don't be a fear behind me. Please only be a troll. It's just a troll. Thank God. If that was a fear, I would probably be dead right now. I don't know where that troll came from. I guess it just respawned on me. Good God, now there's a ton of monsters over here. I mean, even if I don't run into monsters as bad as the fear, maybe I'll just get overwhelmed by sheer numbers. Maybe it'll just throw a billion enemies at me and keep spawning them. Because the bump inflicts 10 damage. Wow, it actually gave me a number that time. That's interesting. More invisible things. Ouch. I guess they're just all going to be invisible now. Awesome. As if things weren't difficult enough. I mean, not that it's that much of a handicap since I can just see them on the map, but still. I mean, come on. Haven't I suffered enough? Where will it all end? I don't know. Oh, hi. I'm sort of juggling my hammers now. That's pretty cool. Alright, I should probably rest again. Oops. Oh hey, whole person is like a projectile. I thought that was another one where you had to be right next to them for it to work. Alright, how much healing do I have left? I still have a few cure serious wounds left. I can probably survive a little while longer. Alright, keeping an eye out for secret doors. I can't bash this or anything, can I? Can I bash it with the club? Nope. It says bash, but that's not a very effective bash. Alright, so I guess I have to start looking for secret doors that Trucine does not show me. Now, if it's a secret door that's activated by a button on the wall, then True Seeing won't help me with that. So I do have to look carefully and see if there's a button on any of these walls. That's one thing that I haven't been actively looking for. I mean, I'm not going to bother. I guess I should, just in case. I'm pretty sure if there was just an illusionary wall, True Seeing would show me where it was. But I guess there's no guarantees in Dungeon Hack. Wait. Okay, that just goes to that door. Okay. Never mind. Button. Who has the button? I really hope there's not something obvious that I'm missing, but I don't think there is. I mean, there's nowhere else to teleport to other than back. I already thoroughly looked at this hallway. Maybe I can just walk through this thing. I haven't tried that. Nope. Okay. Well, you know, I kind of jinxed myself earlier in the video by saying that I haven't gotten stuck in a while. This might be another one that I have to cut and sleep on it. Because, I mean, this isn't like the last one either. I'm not looking for a key because there are no doors that I need to unlock. All the doors are open. I mean, except for this one up in this corner, but I've already been there, so there's nothing up there that'll help me. I checked pretty thoroughly down here for secrets. So I don't think there's a teleporter here that would take me in there. I mean, there's no teleporter that I haven't been through, right? Man, this is kind of frustrating. Oh, True Seeing, why have you forsaken me? I wish there was like a scroll of teleportation or something. Or like a wand of teleport self. No button on this wall. I mean, unless it's a button that I'm not seeing. Unless it's like cleverly camouflaged. You know, I just noticed that some of these patterns in the wall kind of looks like a face. It's creepy. Like, there's its eye, there's its nose, there's a mouth. It's like half a face pushing through the wall, staring at me. There's the same thing, but backwards. The warlord symbol. I don't know. I don't know. Alright, well, the only thing I can think of doing for this video is coming back down here and triple checking to make sure that I didn't miss any buttons that would open up a secret passage here. So I'm going to go down and check that. And if there's nothing, then I'm going to call it for this video and hopefully sleep on it and figure it out tomorrow. And, you know, leave it open to suggestions if anyone watching has any ideas. Hopefully, looks like I can just make a beeline for this teleporter and not have to fight anything. Hopefully, they don't walk backwards and intercept me. Or not walk backwards, but you know, head back in this direction. Alright. Any monsters? Okay. Just one. And it's just a troll, good. No death animation. There is a secret passage on my left. Well, would you look at that? On my left. There is a button on the wall in the dark area. That is so sadistic. True seeing doesn't help you here. Oh my god, this game. Oh, and look at that. There's a billion monsters in there. Okay, well, at least I figured it out. Good job, Duke. You deserve some delicious, nutritious food for that discovery. Man, what a jerk this game is. Alright, I'm thinking I should just make a beeline through those monsters like I did the last time. Oh, but this time I don't have my potion of invisibility. Or my wand of distance. Let's see what this wand does. Oh yeah, that's that wand of fireballs that I found. Oh my god. Oh my god, okay. Alright, well, they followed me. But, okay. Just one of them. See how it reacts to fireballs. This is a scientific experiment to test the effect of fireballs on fears. Okay, got pretty scared for a moment there, but I think I'm still in good shape. Man, this game is a butt. Making me click around blindly on walls, hoping to find a button that opens a secret door. Because I specifically remember mashing my face against that wall. Oh wait, that was a cause serious one, it was not cure. Alright, well, what else do I have? I still have heals, right? Okay, good. Good. Dang it. Gave me the slip. Oh, Christ. Apologies to any Christians offended that I just took your Lord's name in vain just now. I try not to do that. At least not during videos. I mean, I personally don't have any religious affiliation, but you know, I try to respect those who do as much as possible. As long as your requests are reasonable. Alright, so where am I going? Okay. I need to go back through this teleporter. Back into that fray. Holy moly. I should probably go on ahead and rest. Because every time I think I can make it a little bit further without resting, I always end up stuck with no heal spells, or very few heal spells. Besides, Christ doesn't exist in this universe, so it was anachronistic of me to make that reference. I don't know the name of any D&D gods off the top of my head, though. I'm not sure who my character would worship. I used to know some of them, because I played a cleric. You know, that true seeing spell lasts a pretty long time. It's a good value for the money. Okay. Wonder how many monsters are still in here. Just that one, and it went through the teleporter. Nice. I'm not going to worry about that. Wait. Oh. I went through the wrong teleporter. No wonder. No wonder. I got so busy panicking about all those fears that lost track of the goal. Dang it. Oh my god, every time I lure an enemy through the teleporter, I'm gonna have to do this little song and dance. Where I draw it out into an area where I can actually see it. But, you know, patience pays off, I guess. Wanna follow me? No? Well, that's actually good, because this looks like a safe place for me to do my my old pop and bop. That's what I call that move. Pop next to you with the teleporter, and I bop you with my hammer. Get bopped, son. I wasn't sure if that other monster was a troll or a fear, but I'm going to play it safe. I don't know where that other monster went. However, I am sustaining heavy damage right now. Why do I always click on my portrait to get rid of spell list? I do that a lot. It's a bad habit. I guess I could try some of these potions while I'm here. Alright, potion of confusion. Oh yeah! Oh, that's right. I found it in one of my previous videos. Why it's not identified. That would be a potion of protection from fire. I'm moving much faster now. Interesting. If I knew that what that was, that might have helped me earlier in this level. Oil of fiery burning. I forgot I even had that. Right. All of that stuff is identified. Good. Oh, let's, I'm healed up all the way, so no point in even doing that. Where'd I put my... Oh, there it is. See, that one's not invisible. That is so odd. I wonder why some of them are invisible and some of them aren't. I mean, if it's a skill that they have, I don't really understand why they're not all using it. Eofrost. I actually feel kind of good for... I feel kind of proud of myself for figuring out where that secret door was. That was a dumb trick for this game to pull, and I'm glad I found it so easily. I mean, it wasn't easy. I had to fret over it for a little while, but once I started clicking on the walls, then it all clicked. But I should incorporate a soundboard into my LPs. That wouldn't be obnoxious or anything, right? Anytime I make a bad joke, I can hit R for rimshot. Get up and I'm tsh. Level 19, by the way. Woo! Not quite as exciting now that I'm not getting higher level spells. But, you know, more spells is always good. Also, as someone in the comments pointed out, I think it was Pinfeldorf. Sorry if it was someone else. Going up levels also makes your Thaco better, which, you know, is always good. Thaco being the stat indicating your ability to hit things, which is probably. Oh crap! There's something there. All right. Crap. Alright. Get out of camp menu, cast heal. Where the hell are you, son of a bitch? Don't know where it went. I guess it went back through the teleporter, okay. Lightbar was in the red. You know, if I never see another fear again, I'd be perfectly okay with that. Alright, so that one teleported up to that area with the slot machine. Good. Alright, I have a couple trolls, but I can deal with that. They're not fears. The only thing I have to fear is fears themselves. Alright, make sure I'm not getting snuck up on here. Oh yeah, I have that potion of haste, so my thing is refreshing much faster. Didn't even realize. Midnight had a shield, one that would absorb some damage meant for her. Oh. So shields absorb damage. Alright. Heal myself up a little bit more. You know, this would have been so much easier if this freaking barrier wasn't here. Whose idea was it to put that there? Okay, so these are both cursed, because they're showing up as red. Couldn't just let me walk to the stairs, could it? I need to take advantage of my haste while I have it. For some reason, I thought that haste wouldn't affect your attack speed. I thought it would just, like... I mean, it can't really make you move faster, since you move as fast as you can tap the arrow. But I thought maybe it would slow the monsters down relative to you or something. So someone else pointed out that I passed up Bracers of Ogre Power in a previous video, which I'm kind of bummed about. There were a bunch of bracers that I was trying out, but I was just looking at the armor class. I wasn't paying attention to the strength. I could have had a strength of 19. These are just magical bracers. They don't give me ogre power. Sadly. Kinda weird that I haven't encountered a boss yet on this level. Figured I would have found it by now. Well, the haste is still in effect. Cool. I do seem to be killing the fears a little bit faster now. I mean, not even because of the haste, just in general. Fewer hits. Or maybe I'm just hitting more often now that I'm a higher level. What is that? I don't know. It looks scary, whatever it is. It's something I haven't encountered before. I don't want to get close enough to it to try to figure out what it is. Looks like some sort of bull-like creature. Got him. And he dropped a potion of speed. Oh, that's what It was potion of speed, not a potion of haste. And it, I think it dropped this bronze plate mail as well. And it's not as good as what I have. Doesn't buff in any of my other stats or anything. Well, thanks anyway. Okay, so what was that? Umber Hulk. Oh, okay. Well, I thought there was an actual D&D before and they didn't seem it. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present Lucky Level 13. Boom. This has been Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux. I'm Duke of the Bump. Things can't possibly get worse than they were just now. Let me tell you. We are on the way up. Woo! Bye, everyone.